last 5 years, we've grown, almost doubled the size of the company. Now, of course, when you look at that kind of growth, you really are looking for a lot of employees to try to fill the space. And we look for high-skilled employees. We look for people with a background, a BSc background, sciences background. And what we were finding was that there was a large gap in trying to actually get those skilled workers into our workforce, to get as many as possible of these people who are new Canadians into our workforce. They've got some fantastic skill sets, and we find that they bring a lot to the table as far as both skill sets as well as adding to the diversity of our business.
What we found was we were trying to reach different markets, trying to find people shipping to Canada, people shipping from Canada to other countries, and we realized that the candidates we needed were people who had some sort of contact network in their home country, both for potential clients and for potential suppliers, and people who had potential clients and suppliers here in their new community. And so, obviously, immigrants were the best fit for us.
As part of the TRIAC program that we're participating in, and what we've established now is a recruitment procedure where we will hold recruitment events. And again, with the growth that we're looking at, in technologies in Canada, we often need to hire en masse very quickly. And so what we've been able to do with TRIAC is actually coordinate recruitment events where we'll get, quite a few number of immigrants coming in, quite a few of our leaders in the organization who have the interviewing skills, who can work through these resources, and basically work through them in a fashion that we can interview very quickly, we can assess very quickly, and we can make some decisions rather quickly and be able to recruit and get them into the organization within a fairly quick turnaround time.
We have co-op programs. We work with agencies in the Toronto area and recruit new Canadians in that way. So they go through the same process as any new hire. Bring them in. We put them through the same onboarding process that all of our new employees also go through. They go through department training, health and safety training, quality assurance, so everything that a new hire would actually go through. They're assigned a buddy in their departments who will then take them around and show them what needs to be done on a day-to-day basis. Then they will stay with that program between 9 to 16 weeks, depending on the candidate. In the last 10 years, we've had about 400 co-ops, and we've hired on about 200 of them in full-time positions. And we've actually had some of them that have gone on to senior management positions within our organization as well.
You know, as far as the individuals we've hired, you know, everybody here has said it, the attitude, the willingness to learn far outweighs any of the technical gaps that we see in the resources, and they're easy to address. One minor issue was a communication challenge with one resource, and again, leveraging, going back to TRIAC and looking for some extra language training was really the solution, and it was mitigated rather quickly, actually.
That does mean that we need to have some understanding of foreign credentials. But that helps to, often is built up because we have, for example, a large number of Romanians, and if a Romanian applies, usually somebody else can comment on his university.
For us really is the innovative thinking, the different thinking from the different cultures. So when you sit around a room in a meeting room and you look around the room and you've got a diverse culture, the ideas that flow are bar none more than if you sat around the room with one culture in the room. So to be able to have that discussion, that energy around, you know, what do we do with this problem and how do we fix it? The discussions are much more robust, and we're seeing a much better solution coming out of any of our problems that we face.
We have trouble existing without this pool of highly educated immigrants in Toronto. I'm a little embarrassed because I could say what we're doing is not the least bit benevolent. It's just totally selfish. We're out trying to hire the very best people we can, and this has been the result. And if a company in any way discriminates against new immigrants, I think they're just going to end up hurting themselves. So.